Welcome to the Brian Roos Show. I'm here with Glenn. He had an amazing UFO sighting here in Vancouver in 1967. So he's going to tell us about it. Here we go.
Yeah, so it was somewhere between the mid-60s, let's say, give or take a year or two, 1967. Could have been as far back as 65. My mom and dad invited us kids, myself and my sister, to go down and see a play downtown, and we were going to meet another family with their kids. And it was probably going down either Fraser, possibly Main Street, as I recall, headed north. And as we were looking towards the North Shore Mountains, going down the street, on the radio that we were listening to, it was talk radio. I'm not sure what station it was, but they mentioned that there was a UFO being sighted over Vancouver, and it was headed from the west over towards eastward, probably over not English Bay, but the Burrard Inlet.
So that's right behind you here.
Yeah, behind me, right down that way. So if we were headed north, we were headed down either Fraser or Main Street.
Yeah.
And we get out of the car because they said there's object traveling, people are looking at it and calling in. So all the other cars seemed to be pulling over at the same time. We got out of the car, other people were getting out of their cars. They must have had the same station tuned in. And they're pointing at something. We look up and from the west, we see a mushroom-shaped object. Quite
wow.
High.
Wow.
Headed about this fast across the sky.
Yeah.
And it was glowing.
Not very spot.
Yeah, it was oscillating between kind of purple and maybe yellows and greens and pinks. It was kind of a mushroom shaped, if you can picture a mushroom with a dome on top.
Wow.
And
the mushroom, was there like a stem to the mushroom?
It seemed to be. It seemed to be. And it was oscillating colors. And it was, I say, going quite quickly. I don't know how many thousand feet it would have been. If you could put your finger out there, it would have been the size of my pinky.
Okay.
Up that far. So,
oh, wow.
Other people were pulled over and they were doing the same thing. They were looking at it, they were checking it out, and we were all kind of, wow, that's interesting. What is it? Is it a flying saucer? You know?
Wow. Now, what impresses me is that you heard it on the radio, because normally the mainstream media doesn't want to talk about UFOs, it blacks it out, but sometimes they will.
This was the 60s, though, I guess.
You know, there's a big flap in 66, yeah. So maybe it was 66, but that was a big year, 66.
May have been, yeah.
But it could have been any time, yeah, but...
Like I say, that's a long time ago now, but my sister remembers it, too. My mom and dad now are quite elderly, and they don't recall it.
Oh, yeah.
But my sister does, and she talks about it to this day.
Good, good. And then I think you said your sister was inspired to join MUFON, the Mutual UFO Network, because of this experience, right?
She has. She's doing investigations with them, and I'm not sure how often she gets out and does that in this area.
And she's here in the Vancouver area, right?
In the general area, yeah.
Is it okay to say her name for the show?
No, I don't think I should say, just because I'm not permission,
first.
Right?
Yeah,
I would talk to her.
But I'm sure she's into UFO things, but that's fine.
Yeah.
Wow, so well, this is just amazing that you saw. And other cars pulling over, you think that they heard it on the radio or they actually saw it?
Well, I think that they heard it because it was way up there. Not everybody's going to be looking up. I think we heard it on the radio, so everybody else heard it on the radio.
Yeah, and you pulled over.
We pulled over. Now, what station it was, I can't recall.
So you're not sure whether it was Main Street or Fraser, one of those, at least of here.
Yeah, and we were northbound, headed towards the mountains, going downtown to see to some small theater, as I remember.
Yeah.
I think the play might have been called Red Shoes or something.
Oh.
And something to do possibly with ballerinas or ballet, and we were going with another family and their kids.
So if the viewers are dedicated, they go back to the microfilm. What was playing Red Shoes back in the 60s, find out what day it happened, what week it happened.
It was an East Side small theater.
What time of year was it?
You got me.
Do you remember, was it cold or hot, like winter, summer?
I don't really remember.
Okay, yeah, it was a long time ago. So how old were you at the time?
I would have been about 11 or 12, I guess.
Okay. Wow.
Good.
So it also, describe a bit about your emotions, your feelings when you actually saw that. What did it feel like?
Wow. A flying saucer. Looks like a mushroom more than a saucer.
Wow.
That's interesting. You know, what is it? Is it Is it aliens? We don't know what it is, but, you know, it's a UFO.
Yeah, I'm thinking it's a kid's mind. If you're 11 years old, you think, holy man, that's from outer space? Or what did you think?
Isn't that the narrative that since the 50s they've been pushing they come from other planets?
Yeah.
I don't necessarily buy into that one. I think that they're interdimensional entities.
Yeah.
I also think that the technology that we often see up there is our black projects from our very own secretive governments.
It could have been one, even in the 60s, it could have been one of ours.
Could have been one of ours. Yeah, but whatever the narrative they're spinning is, don't believe it because they're lying. You know that, right?
Yeah, thank you.
If they're talking, they're lying. Yeah.
No, just the other day, the Pentagon announced that they have a craft not made from this Earth. It's on the New York Times.
Saw that, yeah.
Yeah, you wonder, wow, that's nice to hear that. They have an agenda behind that, but it's nice that they released that, you know.
Interesting, isn't it?
So also mention these mountains here. You can see behind it, Grouse Mountain. To the left, we can't see Cypress Bowl, but I've heard or suspect there could be an alien base beyond Cypress Bowl.
Is that right?
A lot of sightings around this area, Broward Inlet. The one I saw was right over Kitts Beach.
Yeah.
In that area, going towards Cypress Bowl. Oh. I saw it on 7th Avenue, but it was going towards Cypress Bowl, and you're sort of in the same general area. So.
Yeah. So I guess I'll stick with it was a UFO until somebody proves it was something that came from another planet or whatever.
Yeah.
Everything points towards government secret projects, really, to me. And if they're interdimensional as well, maybe, you know.
Yeah. I think those are two dominant theories in ufology. They could be, you know, craft from other planets, or they could be interdimensional.
Could be.
In ufology, that's a very common view,
Yeah.
Well, this has been great, Glenn. Yeah. I really appreciate your testimony. Thank you.
Awesome. Well, thank you for the interview, Brian.
Okay.
God bless.